Good afternoon, students, and wishing you very happy new year. So today we are going to start lesson number 9, and that is motion and types of motion. Now you all know about what is motion. Now motion means movement of anything from one place to another. Suppose you are coming from home to school, or you are going to some other place, you are going to your aunt's house. That all these things are motion. Suppose I am moving one object from here to here, this is also motion. So in our day-to-day life, we come across many examples of motion. Motion means displacement, change of place of one thing from one place to another is known as motion. So there are many types of motion, and these are divided into two, linear and non-linear type of motion. Now, what do you mean by linear motion? Linear motion means something which is moving in one straight line. Suppose you are watching a moving bus or a moving train is better example. Moving train, when moves from one place, one station to another station, it will go only in one straight line. And that is displacement is only in one line. Suppose it is moving from station A and it is reaching station B, then the movement of train is linear. It is not moving in this way. The train will not move in this way, so it will move only in one line, and that is known as linear motion. So in short, we can say that movement of train is the best example of any linear motion. Or if the road is straight and you are cycling, then if it is in one line, suppose there is no curve in the road or no moves and no direction, so it is always in one straight line, and the motion of such type of objects is known as linear motion. And now again I will summarize. So what is motion? The movement of any object from one place to another place, or displacement. Displacement means changing of place from one place to another place is known as movement or motion. And types of motion, there are two types of motion. One is linear and another is non-linear. Linear, you can see if you are traveling in a train, you can see that the train travels in a straight direction, one straight direction, and that is a linear motion. If you are playing football, it will not be a linear motion because the ball will move in all the directions, isn't it? So it will not be a linear motion. Now we will come to the non-linear motion. When the motion is not in one line, that is known as non-linear motion. Suppose a girl is playing on the slide. She is riding on the slide and she is moving from top to bottom. So in every position, the speed of that girl will not be the same. It will change, isn't it? So the speed of girl will be changed and it will not be uniform. Uniform means it will not be in the same, always same. It will not be same. It will change from place to place. So such type of motion is known as non-linear motion, or non-uniform motion also you can say. Non-uniform linear motion. It is known as non-uniform linear motion. When any object moves in a straight line, but everywhere the change is not, the speed is not the same. It will change. So it is non-uniform. It is not the same in all the points. Now see, suppose you are seeing the marching of soldiers. Have you seen it, everyone? So marching of soldiers is best example of uniform linear motion. Understood? Uniform linear motion. Uniform linear motion means when the movement of any object is always in straight line, And everywhere it is the same. The speed remains the same. It will not change. And if you throw any ball from your, suppose from your terrace, you are throwing any ball, it will go to a far distance. But the motion of that ball will not remain same. The speed will not remain same everywhere. So it is non-uniform linear motion. But soldiers, when they are marching from one place to another, they will have the same speed everywhere. They will march in the same manner. Ek hi unki speed rehti, unki speed change nahi hogi. So wo hai uniform linear motion. Now you can see the another example also for this non-uniform linear. Now coming to non-uniform linear motion. Non-uniform linear motion. When the speed does not remain same everywhere. Non-uniform means when the speed does not remain same everywhere. Suppose the girl, I told you the girl is riding a slide. That's right. When she's riding, she's coming down. As she comes down, the speed will increase or decrease, whatever may be. So the change, there is change of speed. So that is known as non-uniform. It is not uniform. एक जैसा नहीं है, उसमें चेंज है. सो उसको बोला जाएगा नॉन यूनिफॉर्म लीनियर मोशन. एक ही लाइन में मोशन है लेकिन उसमें चेंज है स्पीड में. सो देयर आर टू मेन टाइप्स ऑफ लीनियर मोशन एंड दीज आर यूनिफॉर्म एंड नॉन यूनिफॉर्म. नाउ वी हैव रेड अबाउट लीनियर मोशन एंड नॉन लीनियर मोशन. So linear motion can be uniform and non-uniform. So these are of two types, uniform as well as non-uniform motion. Now this must be clear to you till now. So in non-linear motion, now we are again coming to this topic, non-linear motion. So in non-linear motion, the object does not move in a straight line. And that is non-linear motion. Suppose you are going to park in the evening and you see that children are playing on the swing. So every movement, do they move in a straight line? Do they move in a straight line? They will not move in a straight line. So the motion is not straight. It means that it is not linear, non-linear. The swing will move in this direction, again it will go to the same direction back. Swing means jhula. Have you seen this? So movement is in such manner. It is not in a straight line. So this is non-linear type of motion. Now it will again go back to the same position and come back to the same end. It takes about the same time for each swing or one round. Now, what is another type of motion is oscillatory motion. Oscillatory motion. Oscillatory motion. Now, this is non-linear motion because what do you mean by oscillate? One body when move from one place to another place and again goes back to the same position. This type of motion is known as oscillatory motion. And this type of motion you have seen in the pendulum of clock also. Example is pendulum of clock. When the pendulum of clock moves, it moves to and fro, towards and again back. Understood? So such type of motion is known as oscillatory motion. This is known as oscillatory motion. And the another one is the wings of the birds. Birds also, when they fly, they have wings like this. Again, they are going, coming down wings, again going up. So up this type of motion is known as oscillatory motion, starting from one point, going to another point, again going back to the previous point. So such type of motion is known as oscillatory motion. So I have told you many examples for oscillatory motions. Now again, when you vibrate the tabla or drum also, so there is oscillatory motion. They also show oscillatory type of motion. Tabla or any string, when you move any musical string, it will again go to new position. The string will again go to the previous position. So these are the examples of oscillatory motion. Now the movement is also, we can call it as moving fro and back, or back and forth. It means that moving from one position to another. You might have gone to a circus and all, you might have seen the movements of people on the swing. They move high, again go back to the same position, again move back to one height, again move back. So this type of motion is known as oscillatory motion. Now this motion, you have many examples you have seen in your daily life. Now clocks, hands, the hands of the clock move in a circular manner. Have you seen the clocks hands? They also move. This type of motion is different. They also move in from one position to another position, and again come back to the same position. And जब वो उस position पर फिर से आते हैं तो एक particular time लेते हैं. एक घंटे का time हर बार change होता है क्या? 12 से 1 जब बजते हैं, 1 से जब 2 बजते हैं, 3 बजते हैं, हर बार उतना ही time लेते हैं. 6 every time it will take how many minutes? 60 minutes. So the motion will take definitely the same time moving from one place to another. यहाँ से यहाँ जाने में भी उतना ही time लगेगा, यहाँ से यहाँ जाने में भी उतना ही time लगेगा. और 3 से 4 जब बज रहे हैं तब भी every time it will take 60 minutes. तो एक definite time में वो अपना motion complete कर रही है घड़ी के जो काटे हैं वो. तो उसको हम बोलते हैं पीरियोडिक मोशन. उसको क्या बोलते हैं? पीरियोडिक मोशन. ये जो मोशन है, दिस इज नोन एज पीरियोडिक मोशन. सो नाउ वी आर हियर विद ऑसिलेटरी एंड पीरियोडिक मोशन. इन पीरियोडिक मोशन द टाइम टेकन टू कंप्लीट वन स्पेसिफिक राउंड is always the same. Now this type of motion is known as periodic motion, and this motion is known as circular motion because the hands of the watches are moving in the circular manner. Or fan, the blades also, blades of fan, they also move in circular direction. So if the circular motion is in definite time, एक definite period में वो circular motion हो रहा है, तो उसको हम बोलेंगे periodic motion. Periodic मतलब एक period, एक certain period में वो हो रहा है, तो उसको हम periodic motion बोलेंगे. तो ये थे different types of, these are all different types of motion. So summing up now, movement of any body or any object from one place to another is known as motion. And there are different types of motion, linear and non-linear. So linear means moving in a straight line. Displacement is always in a straight line from one place to another. And non-linear means the motion is not in a line. It may be always different. The path of the moving body is different. Now, linear type of motion can be of two type, uniform and non-uniform. Uniform and non-uniform. Uniform means when the motion is always in the same speed in all the points. And when there is no uniformity, no similar speed, that motion is known as non-uniform motion. So these type of motions we have learned today. Another one is oscillatory motion, then circular motion. Oscillatory means movement of swing or movement of pendulum. These are the best example for oscillatory motion. And then another one is circular motion. Circular motion can be periodic also. Periodic means it will take similar time. So this is for today's lesson. Now we will move further for tomorrow and we will learn more regarding the motion. Thank you.